Morning everyone, it's the Wanderer, and as you can see, we're back in Reading's town centre, but not for long. I'm actually stood outside the Slug and Lettuce, and that's actually quite important for this one, because that used to be the Yates in Reading. However, Yates is permanently gone now, so instead we're going to go to a Yates in High Wycombe. This is viewer request, of course, everyone. This has been requested by Sarah, who's been trying to get a lot of her favourite YouTubers to try a Yates, so I'm happy to be trying it now. We're actually waiting for the 8:50 to get to High Wycombe, which should be here any minute now. And just like magic, if you do like this kind of stuff, guys, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe if you're new, click the bell to be notified when I upload more stuff. We're on our way to Yates. Let's make a move. Where's that bus? Well, we've just arrived in High Wycombe. I have to say the journey was absolutely fantastic. A lot of the, you know, the country roads, a lot of really nice views. So I have to say though, an hour and 40 minutes on that bus, my backside is absolutely sore. But as I say, we're going to be looking for the Yates. We're going to try out the full English breakfast at Sarah's recommendation today. Obviously, as always, we'll rate the service, time, presentation, and of course, the most important one, the taste. Fingers crossed it's good. She is giving it a bit of hype, and fingers crossed it lives up to that. So let's just have a look around High Wycombe. Tosh wants to go to Marks and Spencer's, so we can't deny a lady her shopping. Let's make a move. It keeps haunting me. Can I go for two full English breakfasts, please? One without beans. Yeah, one with beans, one without. And a cup of tea and a pint of Carlsberg, please.
That's £16.
That's lovely, thank you very much. Yes, please, yeah.
All your cutlery and stuff are just probably by the table you passed?
Yes, yeah, I saw that, yeah. That's brilliant, thank you. It's ordered, and it was ordered at 11:07. And I have to say, price-wise, for a full English breakfast, this is probably one of the best values that I've ever gone for. So we've got two full English breakfasts come in, one without beans. Toshko's not a fan of baked beans. £5.49, which I think is absolutely incredible. Gets you two sausages, two bacon, two eggs, beans, one without, two hash brown, button mushrooms, grilled tomato, toast and butter, which I won't be having. So honestly, value for money, that is absolutely fantastic. Someone did say to me in a video recently, by the way, because usually I'll have a breakfast with a Coke or whatever, and they say, how can you have carbonated stuff without with a breakfast? Honestly, and this is going to shock you, I'm not a tea or a coffee person. I know. Am I even British? I don't know. I like what I like, and that's what I like. So service, I think we're going to go into the service, and I'm going to give her a 4. It was veering on a 3. It was just basic on the order, if you watch back the video. But the fact that she was able to come hunt down our table, deliver the tea to us and everything, it was a friendly lady. Service 4. Now, we just wait for the breakfast to arrive, and I hope, for price, it's got to be good. It arrived at 11:22, so I make that 15 minutes. But if I did order just after 11:07, it is actually going to be a five time. And it looked, I don't even know if I can finish it. It looks amazing though, so let's have a look. So it does look really, really nice. Presentation wise, I'm so happy that the beans are not in those little cups that a lot of places try to do. Presentation, I think I'm willing to give it a very nice 4. So that's, what's that? A 5, a 4 and a 4. The taste, if this taste is good, we're gonna have a very high score. Let's start off with those beans because I've already been forked up here. So really sweet. Really nice sweet beans there. I don't want to say they're Heinz. I can't absolutely confirm that they're Heinz. Button mushroom. Love these kind of mushrooms. Here we go, check that out. Button mushroom. Nice flavour. Bit of crunch in that, actually. Really nice. Let's go into the hash brown. It's a strong start so far. Hash brown, here we go. That's actually really decent hash brown, nice crunch, good fluffiness in there, really enjoyable. I think we'll move on to the egg. Oh, just before I go into it, I won't be touching the toast. I don't do toast, as you know. Not going to affect any scores on that, but egg, get a bit of white and yolk in there. That's a decent egg, to be fair, that's really nice. White has a lot of thickness to it. Yolk, decent amount of runniness, not overly runny, really good. Just a few things to go. As I always say, tomato's a tomato, but it has been grilled up very nicely, as you can see. That was a very sweet, very nice tomato. Full of flavor, full of juice. Oh, really good. Right. Bacon, pretty hard to cut actually. Right, here's your bacon. It's not your crispy snap bacon, but it does look nice. My word. Even though it's not the way I like it, the flavor, that was a punch. That was an absolute punch. I think I've got a crispier bit under here actually. Let me have a look here. Had to go underneath the beans to get it, but here's a crispier bit. Wow. This is a really good score so far, guys. Sarah, you're not wrong. Sausage time. For me, this is where a breakfast can be won or lost. Really decent looking sausage. Here we go. That is spot on. That is, wow, that is really good. We're gonna finish this and rate it outside, but I can guarantee you this is a good score for Yates. My first ever time in a Yates. It's kind of sad that the one in Reading's closed, but let's finish this and give you the scores outside. Well guys, I think you already know where I'm going with this. Words honestly can't describe how good that was. Honestly, as far as full English breakfast goes, the only thing that I keep thinking in the back of my head is the price. So I'm trying to compare it to the best full English I've had on this channel, which I think would be the Waitrose one. I think the Waitrose was like the best in taste. But that was £8 something. And I'm thinking of the Waitrose one, and I'm thinking I'm eating this. This is £5.49. This could easily be one of the best full English breakfasts I've ever had on this channel. I have absolutely no hesitation whatsoever in giving the taste a 5. It is honestly, and mainly the price is a big factor, but it is an amazing breakfast as well. Everything on there was great. Usually if you go to somewhere else and you pay £5, like the Munchies breakfast, I know I keep talking about it, absolutely awful. £5.49, one of the best full English breakfasts I've ever had. Why did they close Yates in Reading? I don't know. This will be my nearest one now, and I'll tell you what, I'd have no qualms about coming here more often. This was really, really special. Thank you, Sarah, for the recommendation. I really did enjoy that one. 5 out of 5 taste. That was also a 4 presentation, a 4 service, and a 5 time. I make that a grand score of 18 out of 20. Incredibly high across the board. Really loved it. And would happily do it again. If you have the chance, if a Yates is near you, try their breakfast. I don't think you'll be disappointed. So with that being said, guys, as always, don't forget to leave a like if you like this one, subscribe if you're new, click the bell to be notified when I upload more content. And with that being said, I'm The Wanderer, and until next time, bye for now.